Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and sometime you try to open a program and get an error that the application was unable to start correctly, click OK to close the application. So in this video, I will show you some tips and tricks to fix this issue on your Windows PC. So the first thing you should try is press Windows plus R key on your keyboard, type there regedit and hit OK to open registry editor. Now click on yes option on the screen. After that, you need to navigate on H key local machine. Click to expand the folder, navigate to H key local machine, then software. Then you have to expand Microsoft. Scroll down and find Windows NT. So here it is. Expand it. Now expand the current version folder. Now look for Windows registry key. Click and highlight this option, Windows registry key. Now you have to look for load app init underscore DLLs. Once you find it, double click on it. And make sure the value is 0. If there is any other value like 1, then you have to assign a value of 0. Then click OK. After that, you need to restart your Windows PC and check if the program is working or not. If it is working, then fine. If not, follow the next method. Now we are going to check if there is any conflicting service by any program. So press Windows plus R key on your keyboard again. And type there msconfig. Click on OK. Now you will get system configuration window. Here you have to go to services tab. Now check this option, hide all Microsoft services. After that you have to disable all the services which are not published by Microsoft. So disable all these services, hit apply, then OK. After that you need to restart your Windows PC. After the restart you need to check if the program is working or not. If it is working fine, then there are some services by any other program which is conflicting with your program which you are trying to open. So you need to go to msconfig again, open the system configuration. Go to services again. Now check this option again, hide all Microsoft services. After that you need to enable certain services. Enable half of the services which are not by Microsoft. After that hit apply and OK. Now you need to restart the Windows again and check if the program is still working or not. If it is working, then there are some issues with the services which you didn't enable. If it is not working, then there are some issues with the services which you enabled. You have to repeat this process until you find the conflicting service. So you have to enable and disable certain services in order to find which service is actually conflicting. Once you find the conflicting service, you have to disable that service completely and enable rest of the services. If the conflicting service is by any important program, you have to reinstall that program. Anyway, if you are not facing any issue after disabling all non-Microsoft services, then you can keep them disabled. This method is a major fix for this issue, so you have to disable all the non-Microsoft services. And you need to check which service is conflicting with your program. You need to enable certain services, restart your Windows, enable some more services, restart it, and anyhow you have to find the conflicting service. After that you need to keep that service disabled. But anyhow, if you are unable to fix this issue after disabling the services, then follow the next method. In the next method, we are going to re-register DLL files and the ActiveX control. So go to search and type cmd there. Right click on it and click on run as administrator so that we can open cmd as admin. Here you have to copy certain commands from the video description. So check the video description and copy these commands one by one. So you have to copy and paste first command, after that hit enter. Now you need to copy the second command from video description, paste it here and hit enter. This will re-register the DLL files and the ActiveX control on your Windows PC. After that you need to restart your Windows PC again and check if the programs are working or not. And the next thing you should check is that if you are using a correct region or not. Go to Start and search for Control Panel. Open the Control Panel and go to Region. So you have to open the Region option. Go to Administrative tab and then click on Change System Locale. Here you have to check if you are using a correct system locale or not. If not, you need to select the exact location of your computer or country and region. So click on the drop-down menu and check the exact location. After that, hit OK. Then you may need to restart your computer. So restart the Windows and check if your programs are working or not. If it is still not working, then follow the next method. Go to the Start and then Settings and Update and Security. You need to check for the latest updates for your Windows PC. If there is any update available, install it on your Windows. You may need to restart your Windows again. After that, check if the program is working or not. Now there may be another case that you started getting this issue that application was unable to start correctly after Windows update. So if you have updated your Windows recently and started getting this issue, then you need to uninstall the recently installed update from your PC. To do so, go to Start and search for Control Panel and open it. Now go to Program and Features and click on View Installed Updates. And you have to sort these programs by installation date. So look for the recently installed update and uninstall it. Double click to uninstall the recently installed update on your Windows PC. And after the uninstall, you need to restart your Windows PC again and check if the program is working or not. And all these methods should help you to fix this issue, but if it is still not working, then follow the next method. Go to Start and search for CMD again. Right click on it and run as administrator so that we can open CMD as admin. Now type there SFC space forward slash then scan now. This is a system scan and it will try to find any corrupt operating system files on your PC. If there is any corrupt file, it will try to repair it using an image on your Windows PC. The recent versions of Windows like Windows 8, 8.1 and Windows 10 contains an image file on the C drive. It will help you to repair the corrupt operating system files. So the SFC scan will try to find any corrupt operating system file and it will repair if there is any issue. And all these methods should help you to fix this issue on your Windows PC that application was unable to start correctly. After that, your program would work fine without any issue. And that's all for this video guys, hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos and I will see you in my next video.